फर्टिलाइजिंग एंड एंटी फर्टिलाइजिंग रिएक्शन और एग्लूटिनेशन और वी कैन से द बाइंडिंग ऑफ स्पर्म टू द ओलेमा ऑफ द ओसाइट. फर्टिलाइजिंग इज ए is a glycoprotein present on the plasma membrane of the oocyte. This is present on the plasma membrane of oocyte. Even some specific glycoprotein are present on zona pellucida. Suppose this is the zona pellucida. So the fertilizing is a particular glycoprotein present on ulema. This is ulema and this is zona pellucida. These are composed of monosaccharide. Glycoproteins are composed of monosaccharides. Ectosomal vesicle. The sperm head are having the anti-fertilizing. What is that? Anti-fertilizing is a kind of protein-like substance. Composed of acidic amino acids. Anti-fertilizing is composed of acidic amino acids. These are specific. The fertilizing can bind with anti-fertilizing of the same species. What happens? When the sperms reach, this is the uterus. When sperms reach here is the ostium. Even in the infundibulum there is ostium. Here is the ostium. Hence we can say when you will see the surface of the infundibulum, here is the ostium which is surrounded by fimbriae. Even here is also one opening called ostium. When the sperm passing through the uterine body reaches here, they start capacitizing, and these capacitated sperms can receive the stimuli from the oocyte. Oocyte present over here, they releases this glycoprotein, and that is fused with the fluid of the fallopian tube and reaches the sperms. Now the capacitated sperms can receive this chemical stimuli and they are attracted towards the oocyte. suppose this side the oocyte is present and this side oocyte is not present, then the sperms of this side, in which fallopian tube the secondary oocyte is present, they are being attracted due to the chemotaxis, because this glycoprotein is released and which is dissolved, which reaches the sperms, getting dissolved in the fluid secreted by the mucosal lining of the fallopian tube. So these are this, because these chemicals attract the sperms, and this is called chemotaxis. What it is called? The attraction of the sperms. Attraction of the sperms towards the oocyte due to release of glycoprotein, release of fertilizing is called chemotaxis, is known as some substance are attracted, bodies are attracted towards some particular chemical, then it is called chemotaxis. It is one thing, the function of one function of the fertilizing. Then when sperm reaches the zona pellucida, they bind with this fertilizing. Here are some that specific glycoproteins. And when the sperms penetrate into the zona pellucida and reaches the ulema, then again they bind with the, only one or this will be repelled. Because after one sperm binds with the ulema, that undergoes depolarization. The membrane, it initially remain polarized, means negatively charged. Then when a sperm bind with the ulema of the oocyte, with the ulema, then it undergoes depolarization, or it becomes positive. The membrane becomes positive. That prevents the polyspermy, and this is called fast block of. And suddenly the ulema undergoes depolarization, so it is called fast block to polyspermy. Then another thing, the fertilizing anti-fertilizing interaction, it occurs in such a way as the antigen and antibody react. Hence, it is, this reaction is also known as agglutination. We can define the agglutination as the adhesion of sperm to the egg of the same species occurs through a chemical interaction called agglutination. What is agglutination? Attachment. The adhesion of sperm and egg of the same species. It is species specific. The ovum secretes a chemical substance called fertilizing, which is made up of monosaccharides and amino acids. Whereas the sperm possesses a protein called the anti-fertilizing, composed of acidic amino acids. Thus, the fertilizing of an egg interacts with the anti-fertilizing of a sperm only of the same species. Okay? Again, repeatedly I am telling you. It is species specific. Agglutination ensures the sperm of same species is fertilized with the ovum, with the secondary oocyte. Ephyr lily
in 1914 proposed the fertilization theory. Fertilization theory based on sea urchin and echinoderm. According to this theory, the ovum, the oocyte, releases a chemical substance. Ovum releases a chemical substance called fertilizin, composed of monosaccharides and the amino acids, whereas the sperm surface, possesses a protein, called antifertilizer, according to the theory of Effer Lilly, which is completely based on the sea urchin. Antifertilizing composed of acidic amino acids. At the point of contact, the oocyte produces forms and projection. Where it receives the sperm content, exactly all the except the plasma membrane, all the sperm content are released into the oocyte. When it is released into the except the plasma membrane, the mitochondria, the centriole, everything, they are released into the oocyte, when it is released, the tail is degenerated. Cytoplasm is diffused, and mitochondria and nucleus we will study later what happens there, how they undergo change, the male, it makes the male pronucleus, and the centriole release into the oocyte is also having its nucleus, which is known as germinal vesicle. This is the oocyte. This one you can see, whose acrosomal vesicle is burst out, then it is lost its anterior part of the head sperm. This is the raised projection, is called, this projected part is called reception cone or fertilization cone. The centriole enters into the oocyte. They form the mitotic spindle. The proximal centriole enters. Which centriole enters? Proximal centriole and a distal centriole. The distal centriole already, that is developed the axial filament, The proximal centriole, earlier I had told you, the proximal centriole and is released into the, after releasing into the cytoplasm of the oocyte, that divides into two and produce and develops the mitotic spindle for the first mitotic cell division of the zygote. As I have told you, the fertilization starts with the fusion or union of the male and female gamete and ends at the intermingling of the chromosomes, paternal and maternal chromosomes at the metaphase of first mitotic division of the zygote. Do not forget this one. Then what happens is, as soon as the sperm touches, okay, like this simply I am showing you, touches the ulema, plasma membrane of the oocyte, what happens? The plasma membrane of the oocyte, or we can say the ulema, undergoes depolarization. Actually, it was polarized, the membrane was polarized, but at the magical touch of the sperm, immediately it undergoes depolarization due to the sodium influx. Actually, what happens when the sperm touches the plasma membrane of the oocyte, the sodium influx occurs. Sodium influx from the extracellular fluid. Sodium influx occurs that causes the depolarization. How? The sodium channels open and the sodium influx, what I told, sodium influx occurs that act as the depolarization of the oocyte. What I told, the membrane ulema, the ulema is depolarized, or the plasma membrane of oocyte within few seconds within few seconds undergoes depolarization means became positively charged because of the influx. Why? Because of the sodium influx at the fusion of the plasma membrane of the sperm with the plasma membrane of the oocyte, the ulema undergoes depolarization, which acts as the first block to polysperme. That results in the first block. This depolarization, okay, let me write down here, the depolarization on the when the sperm fused with the plasma membrane of ulema within few seconds the oocyte plasma membrane, I am writing PM, okay, oocyte plasma membrane undergoes depolarization which induces depolarization due to the sodium influx and sodium influx induces in turn stimulates the intracellular release of intracellular calcium. Intracellular calcium is released from the intracellular organelles, endoplasmic reticulum. Release of intracellular calcium ions. And this calcium ion induces the exocytosis of cortical granules, which brings the cortical reaction, which begins the cortical reaction we will study in the next